Oh, it won't be too hot.
Oh, no, it says.
Okay. So can you please introduce yourself?
Swag. So we're rolling?
Yeah.
Okay, hi, no introduction either. You know the name, right? This is Richie Mensah.
Hey, Richie.
What is this about?
Don't worry, you don't need to know. It's a secret project. It's a personal project, so it's not that deep. Okay.
No introduction either, because you know the name, right? But just for sake, this is Richie Mensah right here.
Hey, Richie, you are really a star. Okay, so what do you do?
Okay, so the question what I do is one I've always hated to answer. I'm an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a producer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a songwriter.
Right.
I'm a graphic designer, video editor. What else do I do?
Sound engineer.
Own a record label. A bar, a modeling agency, a branding agency, a school.
Hey, ghetto!
So, in fact, I know what I am. I'm Mr. Entertainment.
Right, okay. Good answer. And how long have you been doing, okay, let's say the music aspect, because that's what you're known for, right? So how long have you been doing that?
Well, professionally,
right?
I'll say since 2003.
Dang.
So that's about 16 years.
So that was straight out of Motown?
Yeah, straight out of Motown. As soon as I finished school, bought mic and started. But successfully, since 2007.
Wow. So the 4 years was jokes?
Oh. Yeah, 4 years was, you know, trying to get it right.
Right.
Then released the first single in 2007.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the first success.
But did you always know that music was what you were going to do? Like, from what age did you know that, yo, this is my path?
The first time I actually sung or anything like that, I was on stage when I was 8 with my brother and my sister.
Christ the King times?
Yeah.
Really?
We did this event.
I feel like I remember.
Yeah. I used to like singing, but I always thought I was charting a path of science and going to be a doctor.
Oh, by the way, Richie is a genius. People don't know. As in, like, he's book smart. People don't know that. I remember, because the thing is, I've known Richie since like
class three,
right?
Yeah.
So we're in the same class, but Richie is actually younger than all of us in the class. He was so smart that they promoted him. He's like a math and science genius.
Oh.
People don't know that.
And now I'm using it to do la la la. No, but
I hated Richie because we can't answer that question, and then the teacher will be like, let the small boy wonder or something outside. Then Richie will answer it, and he'll get it correct. And he'll be like, and I was like, so just sit down.
I had those usual dreams. My dad was a doctor, so I said I was going to be a surgeon.
So that was the plan at first, was that you were going to...
That was the plan.
Okay.
So music was just a passion. It was just something I liked. And I used to disturb people with my singing
all plenty. The time.
All the time.
In Motown.
They used to say I should keep quiet in class.
You'll be there and then Richie will start singing. And Farid will say, no, Richie.
So it's actually one person I should thank is Ken Caffrey.
Right.
Because I didn't plan on doing music professionally.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't going to throw the science away ever.
Right.
So when he asked me why I chose to do science and not music, and I told him, I love music, but I like how the scientific approach to things.
Right.
So he asked me, have I ever heard of sound engineering, which is the science part of music?
Wow. I never knew this story.
Yeah. So when he said this, I was like, okay, interesting. So I went to start doing research. Then I found out about producing, found out about the actual science and like learning about the ear, which was biology.
Right.
Learning about waves, which was physics and everything.
Yeah,
yeah. So I realized, okay.
Yeah, you're not too far off.
Exactly. So then I started heading towards that. So when I finished school, the sad part was they don't offer sound engineering in Ghana.
Oh, they don't at all?
At all.
In any university?
No.
Wow.
So I couldn't get it done professionally.
Mm-hmm.
So when I finished school, I just realized, Charlie, let me just use this time to learn. So from going on the internet to going to buy my own sound engineering books and figuring it out step by step by step by step, and voila.
So that's just how you started. You just dove like right into it.
Yep.
What?
So everything self-taught.
Wait, so you didn't go to any like university and do? Why did I think you did this?
I didn't.
But how? Okay. So I know Miss Mensah. So Richie's mom was a teacher in Christ the King. So I know Miss Mensah, and then I know your dad.
Mm-hmm.
How were you able to convince them that, yeah, no university, I'm going to do music?
Thankfully,
uh-huh.
They got divorced, so I didn't have to convince my dad. That would have been a problem.
You're not married.
And remember those days,
uh-huh.
When you finished senior high, you had 1 year before going to university.
Right.
So I told my mom that, okay, I'll go to university and continue with the science and all.
Yeah.
But within this 1 year,
mm-hmm.
can I use it to prove myself?
Right.
That maybe this music thing could work.
Yeah.
So it was kind of a challenge. So I started, you know, I was using my small money to go and buy a computer mic, be some Yawa computer mic. I couldn't afford a stand. So my biology gassed, physics gassed, chem gassed.
It's big enough.
I would put it on the PC and put the mic on top.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So my science, you know, helped in the studio. So after a while, after like 3 months, then my mom noticed that,
you're serious with this thing.
Yeah, and people were coming to the studio willing to pay and record.
What studio?
In my room. Albert, you know, my big brother went to uni.
Okay.
So I went to sleep in his room.
Okay.
And converted my room to studio.
Oh.
So when he comes for vacation.
But where did you get the money to buy all the studio?
So I didn't have studio equipment. It was just my computer and that computer mic.
What?
So when my mom saw that, when she saw,
Ghanaians do.
People are coming to record
with
this lousy equipment.
Right.
So then she took a loan
and
bought me equipment.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Miss Mensah.
Like, this wouldn't have happened though. She used her salary to take a loan and then bought me an actual mic. Then,
she believed in you.
Yeah.
Well, why do you think she believed in you? Is it because like you were just naturally, like I said, you were a genius, like you're naturally smart. So she knew that you won't make any Yawa decision.
I think that was part, and also she believes in pushing people when they're going in the right direction.
Okay.
So when it was just me talking, I want to do music, of course she was skeptical.
Right.
But after 3 months and she realized that, with no help,
this is what you can do.
Exactly. And then she said, okay, let's take the risk, and she took the loan.
I never knew this.
It wasn't easy. Hey, I mean,
that makes sense why you spoil her like this these days.
Paying off that loan wasn't easy for
her. I'm sure.
Because, of course, you can imagine, it's not like I made back the money.
No, instantly.
Yeah. It took years and years and years. So when that 1 year time was almost up,
mm-hmm.
and I was supposed to go to Tech.
Okay.
Because they do better science than Lagos.
Right.
So then I sat down and I spoke to her and I said, Mommy.
Look at what.
Yes, it's working. Like, I know I'm not there yet, but as you can see, if I keep going, I can make it.
Right.
So we came to a compromise.
Right.
I went to NIIT
mm-hmm.
because NIIT's program was 3 days in a week.
Right.
And also was close to the house.
Mm-hmm.
So it means that I can have more time to be able to work on the music.
Okay.
And I'm not abandoning the education.
Right.
So I went to NIIT while I continued
my
music.
And what was it?
I did software engineering.
Oh, yuck.
Yeah. I remember my teacher used to fight with me because he said I was one of the best in the class.
Mm-hmm.
And he had drawn this whole plan for me.
And then you see, you know, like, music is
what. Yeah, then every day I'm talking music, and he's always complaining. And I told him this thing, I'll never forget. Mm-hmm. I told him that if I continue with the software engineering, I'll become a good and regular software engineer.
Right.
I'll probably find some job in a company, sit there and code and be average.
Right.
But when I do the music, I can be exceptional.
But what made you feel like you could do it? Like, where did you get this confidence from?
Maybe my ego was just too big.
but you were right.
Yeah, I felt it. Like, when I create music,
even
at the point when I didn't have the know-how, it felt like it was almost as good as what the professionals were doing.
Let me just tell you something. I remember those times in class. Where's Richie? You were in the music school all the time.
They used to call me music school prefect.
Yeah, I'm like, you just, it's like you, it was a, you loved it.
Yeah.
You were there all the time. And I wasn't ever in school. But when I was there, you weren't there.
It was my passion. And me, one thing I've come to learn, like I always say, scientific approach.
Yeah.
Passion isn't enough. Yeah. You need to be dedicated to it.
Yeah. You have to be consistent.
Yeah. Motown, look, one reason I love Motown is... I'm sorry, I do. Because Motown made me. Mm-hmm. If I had gone to another school, mm-hmm. I'd have probably just studied, and not given the music a chance.
Why? What about... Is it Ken Caffrey? Just Ken Caffrey?
Not just Ken Caffrey, but Motown has this air of you can be anything.
Why didn't I get that? I definitely didn't feel it.
No, it's true. Like, they okay.
I felt the opposite in Motown.
Maybe because you were a day student.
No, there's no way I could be in the boarding house.
When you're in the boarding
house. Oh, hell. Okay,
I think
certain
people don't want to conform. Yeah. And that's the beauty about a place like Motown. Even though they'll tell you these are the rules, mm-hmm. they allow you to not conform.
Okay.
It's like, my seniors used to complain all the time.
I'm just listening to, I don't agree with anything you're saying, but you say it and I'm saying okay.
My seniors used to complain all the time that I'm always in the music school.
Yeah.
I'm always drama club, I'll go to drama club and all mm-hmm. those things, but they never stopped me.
Right.
They got it.
Just talking.
They'll talk, but mm-hmm. it's cool. Like, they'll come, my mom could come and look for me and then, the seniors would say, oh, Richie, man, I was in the music school.
Of course, and you'll be there too.
Yeah.
So, okay, so you knew for sure and then you think it's Motown, if you went to any other school, you wouldn't have been.
I wouldn't have. Because Richie. I think no other school has that balance.
Mm-hmm.
Some schools are very free, mm-hmm. but they don't get you to actually sit down and learn.
Right.
And some schools are too strict.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't get the extracurricular activities right. and all those things. I mean, Motown, from the games to, there was too much extracurricular.
I can't even imagine having to live in that. I can't even pass by the school today.
Mm.
I can't pass in front of the school.
That was actually, see, and that's the thing. I feel bad for you because I don't remember class. If I remember Motown, class is not what...
Don't feel bad because I was only there for like 1 year. But okay. So then you... Miss Mensah bought into it. You didn't have to. You went to NIIT mm-hmm. and then you became a musician.
Yeah, and then I just had to keep...
So did you start Lynx immediately?
Yeah, I started Lynx immediately.
Wow, so you're just like, okay, I'm going to set up my... What was it? Was it a record label when you started?
When I started, it was just a studio.
Okay, so it was Lynx Studio.
Yeah. Okay. The record label idea came because I studied the trends. You know how I wanted to do R&B and hip-hop and this whole that are beaten?
Yeah.
And Ghana...
It didn't fly.
No, Charlie, if you were not singing in Tree and it's singing High Life, no one was minding you. But I realized one thing.
Mm-hmm.
I realized that I wasn't the first to try and do this kind of music.
Okay.
Some people had done it before me.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe like every 2 years, one person will release a hit,
mm-hmm.
then nothing happens. Then 3 years later, another releases a hit,
mm-hmm.
then nothing happens. Wow. So I realized it's not like I was being the most innovative person.
Right.
It's just that nobody had been able to have a plan where they could continue. Mm-hmm. A ripple effect.
Right.
So I said, okay, then let me create my own ripple effect.
Mm-hmm.
Let me create a record label.
Right.
So that when I release R&B...
Then somebody else.
Somebody else. Then the next person. Mm-hmm. And the next person. So that it becomes a trend. Right. And not just a one-off thing.
Wow. That's you get so me. Smart.
So then started signing artists. So signed people like Asem.
Yeah.
Signed OJ Black. Signed some people nobody ever even heard about.
Yeah.
And also... started influencing some of the established artists.
Right.
Like, I recorded for Tiny for free from like 2005 till now. Because he was somebody who could make a difference. He already had the name. I'm now trying to make the name.
Right.
If I play a hip-hop beat for Tiny, instantly it's on radio.
Right, right, right.
Do you get me? So I needed his platform to make a change.
Right.
And who doesn't like free beats?
Of course.
So Tiny actually came to the studio because someone wanted to feature him on a song.
Okay.
So they brought him to the studio and then he heard the beats I was doing and he was like, hey, small boy, where are you from?
Exactly.
So he said, can I make a beat for him? I said, hey, you want me to make a beat for you? I opened the folder, there's already beats there waiting for him. So
when you started, you were producing to...
Yeah.
Oh, really? Okay.
Mm-hmm. So I learned how to play the piano in Motown.
Okay.
Yeah. That's why I kept going to the music school.
Hey! That music school, they should name it after you.
So all this was self-taught. Because I wasn't in actual music school.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't have a music teacher.
Right.
So one reason I had to be there so much was, unlike the rest who would have a teacher who said, do this, do that, I have to go and sit there and figure it out for myself.
What was Ken Kaufu for you? He was a music teacher, right?
He was a music teacher for the music students.
Oh, got it.
Yeah. So
you you just went sit down and learn.
By force.
Wow. So then, okay, so I remember when you were Richie the artist, mm-hmm. and then you just dropped it. And yeah. then you started producing, and then you became like the exec and stuff. Why the change?
I started with all three. I started as the exec, mm-hmm. the exec, the producer, and the artist.
Right.
I won't lie. I started producing so that I could produce my own music.
Right.
Because okay. I wanted to do R&B.
Yeah, yeah.
And everyone was producing Jama. Mm-hmm. When we were in Motown, uh-huh. we actually went to a studio to record. Hey. The Jama beats they played for
That's
R&B
right.
song, pa.
Yeah, like...
Quickly. So it wasn't just me. It was mm-hmm. myself, Edwin Ferguson, Selassie, and Francis. We're all in Motown together. We formed a group.
Okay.
So the Lynx was mm-hmm. the name of our group when we were leaving okay. Motown. And Edwin played keyboard mm-hmm. and the flute.
Okay.
Selassie played keyboard and violin.
Okay.
I played keyboard and guitar.
Okay.
Of course, they played it professionally. I played it like 2x4.
Right.
And then Francis was also just a singer. And we all sung.
Okay.
So we went to the studio and then went to record that Jama song.
Yeah.
And we were like, but we play.
Yeah.
We play instruments.
Why?
We've gone to the studio for them to play lousy instruments
yeah,
for us.
Yeah.
Why don't we do it ourselves? So I had a friend, Sally. He was a computer genius, way ahead of me.
Right.
I'm not allowed to say this on camera, but he cracked the software for me.
That's right.
Because we couldn't afford to buy it. Cracked the production software. Uh-huh. Then we just connected a keyboard, started small, and then started learning how to produce so we could do our own thing.
Wow.
But along the way, within that like 1 year, within the first like 3 to 6 months, mm-hmm. Francis left the country.
Oh. Okay.
He went to do medicine in the States.
Yeah.
So one down, mm-hmm. you know, then Selassie.
Everybody scattered.
Yes, everybody just scattered and it was left with me. So mm-hmm. had to continue. So just made the record label Lynx and
right.
then kept it going. So suddenly I was a small boy
right.
with a big company mm-hmm. and a big career. Mm-hmm. And it was too much to handle.